now to the men, where South Korea had won the 500 metres for three Universiades in a row until 2 years ago in Turkey, where France's Thibaut Fauconnet rather upset the apple cart. Lee Hyobeen, a man on a mission then and a hot favourite to take gold after breaking the Universiade record in the semi-finals. Patrick Duffy of Canada expected to be his closest challenger. Lee powering away from the start to take that all-important inside line. The Korean looking to dominate this race like he had all the others through the heats. Japan's Hiroki Yokohama also making a decent start, but soon finding himself overtaken by both Duffy and then Xi Jingnan of China. The tussle between Duffy and Xi really lighting up this race. Xi taking a dive down the inside, but then drifting wide and allowing the Canadian to move back into second place. He then had another pop on the final lap, but couldn't make that stick either. Lee away and clear for gold, with Duffy and Xi completing the podium. That the seventh time then that South Korea have won the 500 metres in Universiade history, while Duffy came up just short of being a fourth Canadian winner of this event, instead matching Liam McFarlane's silver medal from 2 years ago. As is often the case, this race almost won at the start. Lee in pole position and making no mistake off the line, sewing up the inside and never letting anyone even look like getting past throughout the race. Do spare a thought for Hiroki Yokohama though, fourth in the 1500 metres on Wednesday night and now fourth again in the 500. Lee Hyobeen continuing Korean domination on the short track. They've now got two golds from two men's events thus far in Trentino, with a promise of more to come.